Jo, hello and welcome to YouTube and my channel. Nu kommer jag byta till svenska. I'm going to talk Swedish a little bit and then change to English. Så välkomna ni svenskar till min kanal. Jag kör annars bara på engelska. Men jag kan inte vara tyst för att Pontus Rasmusson gör något som ingen talar om. Och det är att han strider mot lagen på YouTube. Januari så blev det en ny lag här på YouTube och menas på att om man gör videos som är tillägnade barn så måste man klicka i en knapp för att visa att man gör det. Vad som händer då är att man förlorar reklamintäkter. Reklam, förlåt. Man förlorar kommentarer. Jag vet inte om man förlorar även tummen upp och tummen ner. Jag tror inte det. Men i alla fall, man förlorar en hel del på att göra så. Och det har inte han gjort. Så om ni går in och kollar på hans video så har han fortfarande kvar kommentarer och så vidare. Och reklam. Och det har ingen annan tagit upp. De tar bara upp hans historia om telefon som ringer in, barn som ringer in. 10 kronor dit, 10 kronor dit. Blir av med flera tusen. Men Pontus Rasmusson gör något riktigt, riktigt fel. Han, om inte han byter till YouTube Kids, så kommer han att, om de får reda på det, YouTube och denna lagen Koppa, så kommer han få betala 200 000 kronor per video. 200 000 kronor per video. Om ni räknar upp alla hans videos så ser ni att det är en hel del. Det är det enda jag vill säga. Jag vill bara tillägga detta att det är väldigt viktigt och det är någonting som många kreatörer har missat. Now let's switch to English. Okay guys? So, let me tell you something. There is a Swedish YouTuber called Pontus Rasmusson and Swedish YouTube are going bananas. Regarding content and things around this guy, because he's like a TikToker and also YouTuber and does a lot of things on Instagram, and he was going live, and then they asked kids if they wanted to speak with him, they should call a number, and every time they call this number, it cost 1 euro, okay, or dollar, $1 or something like that. But it didn't tell them that if they didn't go through to him directly, that it would cost money. So these kids, they called hundreds of times. So hundreds of times equals $1 or 1 euro is a lot of money. And the parents are now very, very upset regarding this and are asking him for paying back the money because they think he's a scammer. But he's doing this legit. And he's not feeling sorry about it. He did a video after half the YouTube community went after him and told him, you need to pay them back, you need to tell you're sorry and so on, because he's almost at 100k subs, which is pretty huge in Sweden. But he didn't do it. So next video came out, next video and so on. And then finally one video came out. And that video was, in our opinion here in Sweden, pretty shitty. He was asking for, he told everyone he was sorry. He didn't say that he's going to pay back the money. And he has lost a lot of subs because this happened. So, to lure the kids in again, he told them for every sub, he got, he was going to donate one crown. That's like, I don't know what crown one crown is, and 1 cent or something like that. That's not so much for every sub, because he wanted to grow to 1K, 100K. Okay, so now the YouTube community in Sweden is going bananas over this shitty video that he did. I'm gonna show you the video a little bit. I think he might take me down. If he will, I'm gonna upload a new video without his content in it. But this guy, he is so cringy, so goofy, so he really don't belong on YouTube. He belongs on YouTube Kids, and he hasn't changed it to YouTube Kids. So I think Kappa will finally get him in the future, and then he will have to pay a lot of money because of this. So I believe the same thing is going around all over the world. People are asking for subs for money and so on, which I told you guys in another video. So be careful, kids. Don't donate so much money. Ask your parents. Stay nice, stay friendly. Have a great day. That's it for me today, guys. If you want me to tell you guys more regarding this, please do comment down below. This was just a video, and I'm using my Osmo Pocket for this content because my regular camera is back at work, because I have some fun video to release this week. So it's still there. Yeah, that's it. Have a great day. Peace out from Sweden. Hej då allihopa, och om ni är nya, prenumerera gärna. Ni får skriva på svenska. Ja, det var väl allt jag hade att säga idag. Och Pontus, fy dig. Fy dig! Ditt
Last September, we announced a series of changes that we'd be making to better protect kids and their privacy on YouTube, and to address the concerns raised to us by the U.S. Federal Trade Commission. Starting today, to comply with COPPA, the Children's Online Privacy Protection Act, and other laws, these changes will go into effect. This means from now on, any content made for kids will have certain features limited or turned off to lessen data collection and use. Hi, I'm Lauren, the head of family partnerships at YouTube. We know this is a big change, so let's go over what you'll now see on content that's made for kids. On the watch page of any video made for kids, you'll no longer see personalized ads. You will continue to see ads that are based on the context of the video, not user data. In other words, you'll continue to see ads on these videos, but they may be less personalized. In addition, you won't see other creator monetization features like Super Chat or the merch shelf, which require user information. You'll also notice comments, live chat, notifications, and playlisting turned off, and you won't be able to use the mini player. You'll still be able to subscribe to the channel, and all those videos will be available in the subs feed of your YouTube app. Channels that are entirely targeted towards kids will also have some features turned off, including stories, the notification bell, and the community tab. Again, all of these features rely on user data. So for videos that are made for kids, these features as they stand today must be limited or turned off to comply with the law. YouTube is not and has never been for people under 13. We remove thousands of accounts per week when we discover they belong to someone under 13. But the FTC investigation raised the concern that given the increase in shared devices, kids may be watching kids' content on YouTube unsupervised. And we can't control how people and families decide to use YouTube together. So we have to make these changes to distinguish what content is made for kids on YouTube, and then ensure we handle data for that content in a way that protects kids' privacy. We are committed to continue providing high-quality kids content for free through the YouTube Kids app, which is available on mobile devices, computers, and TVs. We've recently expanded signed-in support so that parents can access kids' profiles and control their child's experience on the YouTube Kids app across even more devices. We know these changes may have significant impact on creators making kids' content. We're committed to helping them navigate this new landscape. Thank you for watching.